G'day folks, Ben from Stowed here today, showing you how to set up and pack away the 230 Panther 1600 aluminium hard shell rooftop tent. Hit it. This rooftop tent's got a welded aluminium hard shell, has a small footprint for utes and dual cabs, and packs up really easy with bedding inside. Before we dive in, we've got loads more content like this on our channel, so make sure you like and subscribe below. Now let's jump into the product. Starting with the basics, the tent weighs 72 kilos, and it's about another 3 to 4 kilos for the accessories and things that come with it. And it measures 158 centimeters length that way. So this is the way it would be mounted on the car. 124 centimeters in width. And it's about 30 centimeters for just the tent from the bottom to this point here. By the time you add the rails that sit on the bottom and the roof racks here, it's about 35 centimeters of height. Bit of a walk around of the tent. This is a 2mm welded aluminium shell that sits over the top here. It's got a powder coated or painted nice durable finish on top there, so heaps of protection. And that means you can mount a little bit on top here. So they're included. These are fixed rails on the top here. Really designed just to put, say, a solar panel or something light on top of the tent. It's not designed to carry a heap of weight. They don't actually give a weight rating for these, but I'd probably stick below 10 kilos, to be honest. If we come around to the back and I'll show you the hinges, we're a bit squished in the corner of the shop here, but you can see down the back we've got 1, 2, and 3 stainless steel, heavy duty stainless steel hinges. And these hinge the lid lifting across this way. Now, the rooftop tent runs this way. So this is the side and this has to be the passenger side of the vehicle. And this lid comes out. So as it folds, it comes out into this space here. You need about 25 centimeters clearance between the edge of the tent and whatever you've got mounted here that might sort of, it might hit as it opens up. So you can't put an awning right up next to the tent here. There's nothing specific on the back of the tent, just the logo and obviously sort of the shape, aerodynamic shape to the cover. But on the front here, we'll just show you that we've got, apart from the logo, you've got a over center buckle here, which can be locked. So you can actually lock that closed. And then this is just a Velcro safety strap here. So it's just two mechanisms to hold it closed. A handle in the middle, which you do need to attach when you, after you've bought it, it comes with fittings to be able to do that. And then you've got another couple of buckles there. So the measurements of the Panther are such that it's got a slightly smaller footprint, so it's suitable to, say, fit on a dual cab, on a tray of a dual cab, or on a smaller roof rack, because it does actually fold out to make the most of the full length of the tent. And this extra height also allows space inside for bedding. So at the moment, you'll see when we unpack it, I've got a double sleeping bag rolled down this side of the shelter here inside, so it's protected from the rain. Now it's important to note that you can only mount this one way on the vehicle. So what I'm looking at here is the front. The back end has not got this sort of aerodynamic shape. It's a little more sort of, is a little blunter. The air's not gonna run over that side as easily. So it is designed as such that I would be standing at the front of the vehicle here. This folds up towards the passenger side and the bed will fold over the driver's side of the vehicle. You can't change that orientation. That's how it needs to be set up. As for inclusions that come with the tent, down on the floor here, we've got, this will all make sense later when I set it up, but this is a pole that goes inside and another little pole that's for weather protection. You get an LED light, which is a little controller on there that clips onto this pole here inside the tent. So you've got light. You can run off an USB power bank, so you've got light inside the tent. You do get, actually we'll start with the poles here. These are flexible metal poles, which are used for the awning at the front and also the window awnings on the sides. I'll show you more on that shortly. You get a bag of, a couple of pegs and a couple of guy ropes, which are just used to secure the front of the tent down if you need to. And then you get a bunch of fittings. So we'll park a little repair kit there. Spanner, Allen key, use that to put the handle on the front, which doesn't come attached. These are little bolts that you can use on the rails that are on top of the shelter. And then you get a combination of these fittings here. So these are just M8 bolts with lock nuts on it and washers. And then these channels here, which go inside the channels that run underneath the shelter, and they combine with these brackets here to make this here. And this is what you're gonna use to actually mount the tent. So just have a look underneath. We've got these aluminium extrusions here and these are used to mount the tent. I guess you could move these if you wanted. You'd have to drill new holes into the tent, but it's not recommended. They're situated in a spot that gives the tent stability, so it's got support throughout and you wouldn't want to move them too much closer because it would just, you'd end up with a tent sort of rocking, potentially more flex in the middle if you moved them out. So just leave them where they are. These have got 80 centimeter centers from one to the other, one at the other side here, and they run pretty much the full length of the tent. So about 150 odd centimeters of length for these guys. And they work with this bracket here. Now I'll slide this in place to show you how this would look when it's on your car. So if I'm standing at the front of the car here, we've got roof rails on the car that are running along this way, and the roof rail goes through here. These slide into this rail. You tighten this up and it sandwiches the roof rail in between. So there's one of these at 4 points, or six if you wanted to get extra brackets if you had three roof rails, securing this to the tent. So that's how you mount the rooftop tent to your car. So once you've got it mounted, there are little plastic caps here that fit over the end of the rails there just to finish it off. Now, with regards to mounting it on the roof, you do need to take into consideration both your roof bar ratings, how much weight your roof racks or roof bars can take, and also the roof load rating of your vehicle. So just check up on those things, because some roofs only have, say, 100 kilo rating. So by the time you put a 70 odd kilo tent on there and some roof bars, you can't really put much else on there. So just check into your vehicle what it's capable of carrying on the roof before you go ahead and buy one of these to install it on a car. Now, setting the tent up, I'm just going to step up on the pallets here. Firstly, we undo these straps here. These are just safety Velcro straps, so undo those and just let them hang. They're all attached, so you can't lose them. And then we undo the over center buckles here. If these were locked, obviously we'd take our padlock out, but I undo that. These can be adjusted when you do it up, if you like, to adjust the tightness. One on each side. And then this is now ready. There are gas struts inside ready to sort of lift this up. So just push this up. Obviously, if this was on the car, you'd be standing on the ground, you'd push this up. If I just push that up now, it'll get to a point where the gas struts take over and it lifts up automatically. There's a strap here that you use for pack down, so you can pull this down afterwards, but just leave that in place there for the moment. Now, there's a couple of elastic straps running around here that you need to put in place when you pack it up. These just pull all the fabric in, but we just got to pull them out of the way to set it up. So if we pull it over the side here, there's a metal hook in underneath here just to secure these straps to keep them out the way when the tent is set up. Just watch they don't get caught up on the buckles, on the latches for the over center buckles there. It's probably a whole lot easier to put them in place when you're standing underneath the tent. There's a second strap there. So once these are secured down out of the way, we have a ladder cover that sits over the ladder here just to protect it from rubbing against the fabric. You can roll this up after, but just loosen it and grab the ladder. Now the ladder is actually attached to the tent. If this was on top of the car, you could undo this strap here and extend the ladder out so you could pull it down, but I'm on the floor here at the moment, so I don't need to. But if we just pull the ladder here now, and it shouldn't catch on anything. If you feel it catching, then just stop and find out what's being caught, but it should just undo easily and fold down into place. Now the ladder extends out to 2.3 meters. You can extend it out, you hold this, there's little buttons underneath here to lock this in place. So when you fold it up, you push these and push it all up into place. Just be wary when this is undone, that can just sort of fold out. When you set this up, put the ladder out as far as it will go and then push it up from the top first. So if it needs to be shorter, collapse the top section, because you want this to come up, and this is going to be not the right angle here at the moment, but this wants to be at about 75 degrees to the ground, because this ladder actually forms structure or support for this end of the tent here. You can roll this up or leave it uncovered if you like. There's a little pocket there. Roll this up and secure it up here so that it's out of the way. And that's the tent largely set up, but we need to put some poles in for the fly sheet. So the fly sheet is attached. We're sitting up over the top here. So just pull this down over the front. And we grab our bag of poles and they're color coded. So we need the red ones here for the awning at the front. So grab those two out and the black ones can stay aside. These go in the front here. If you look at the front, above where the boot bags are, boot bags got caught up there again. Underneath this flap here, you've got a little hole there. These insert into here and they flex up with the hook pointing downwards. And then underneath the fly sheet here in the corner, there's an eyelet. Attach that eyelet. We'll put the red tab through the eyelet and just let the tension of the pole and the tent hold it into place. You can see that's gone in there now. This is under tension and it's holding that out into place. Do the same thing on the other side, and then We go down to each corner. So if we follow down the tent here to the base, there's a Velcro hook and loop tab here. This just gets attached up underneath the base. There's some Velcro strips there, or hook and loop strips, just to hold that into place. And we do the same thing on the other side. Now, while I'm down the side here, I'll show you the windows, how we can set these up. So you've got a few options here. You can just roll this up, leave it secured. We've got both a mesh and a solid panel underneath there. Probably a preferable way to do it is to grab two each of the black poles. Now, this window is mirrored on the other side, so exactly the same thing on the other side. And these go in the same manner as the awning poles. So down here, you've got little holes that this will insert into, and then flex it up with the hook pointing downwards, and then the eyelet in the corner of the awning here just hooks over the top, and that stays in place under the tension of that pole. Same thing at the back here, you've got another hole here, insert the pole, flex it up, and hook the eyelet over. One other thing are these little weather flaps that go over where the hinge sits here. So there's Velcro or hook and loop on here and on the actual tent there. This just sort of hooks in place. The hook and loop goes underneath there as well. Just stick that on there, and it just covers that gap there up to give it a little bit more weather protection and also to keep the breeze out. And back around to the front of the tent, I've grabbed the peg and the guy ropes here, and also this pole with my light attached. I'm going to put them inside and show you how that goes on shortly, but I just want to show you how you can use these, because it's not immediately obvious what these are for. Now, up under the corners here, there's metal hoops here. Now, 23-0, I can't find anywhere where they documented what this is for, so I'm making some assumptions that you can attach your guy rope to this, use the peg to peg it to the ground, and that's going to hold this side of the tent down. This is the side that's folded out, so it just gives a bit more security, keeping in mind that this is the spot you walk under towards the driver's door here. So I guess if you park for a long time and there is a fair bit of wind and the wind picks up under there, you want to make sure this side of the tent is secured down nice and firmly. Now, it's really dark inside the tent because of the LST fabrics that 23-0 use, so I've got a light to use in here. Now, this pole serves as kind of a safety thing, but also as a bit of a weather protection thing. So get a little extra short pole here, just attach that onto the pole as well. So on here now, we've got our LED light with the cable that we can run to. There's power pockets for USB power banks that you can tuck it into. And just leave that one hanging there, it'll make sense shortly. Now, there's a C hoop on one end that goes at the door end. And then on the other end, there's just a cap on it. So the cap goes towards the back, which is where the hard shell is. And there's a loop at the top here. This goes through that loop and just pushes against the shell at the back there. And then this side here clips up against the frame. There's a hoop frame that runs over here. It's covered in fabric. And this just clips over that frame. There's a lever lock on the pole here. So just extend that out to make the top nice and firm, and that just gives a bit of stability. It also ensures that this, in the event of really heavy wind, doesn't blow closed while you're sleeping in it. Now, this little pole here simply folds up this way, just stays there under its own tension, and that just creates a little bit of a peak in the otherwise flat roof, just to allow water to rain off if it is really heavy rain. And now on rain, it's quite probably worth mentioning that the awning that I set up at the front there, the windows on the sides here, you can actually set them up once you're in the tent. So if it is really heavy rain, you could pull up at the campsite, fold out the main portion of the tent, just leave the fly draped over the top, crawl inside, and then you can open these windows from the inside to reach out, and you can actually put all those poles in place from inside here, and you can do the same thing with the poles at the front there. So you don't have to be on the outside of the tent to set it up. Now, I'll just tuck this out of the way because I want to show you at the end here, I've actually got a double sleeping bag rolled up in here, which is in here when it was packed up. So this is a nice warm sort of minus 10, minus 12 degree synthetic sleeping bag. Tucks in this space here. So that end of the tent folds up to about here. And then this roof, or the mat finish is here, but this roof or cover folds up so that it meets this spot here. So you've kind of got this space here to fit bedding into. Now, I don't recommend rolling your bedding up into a sort of a tight compressed ball, because that then kind of creates a bit of a obstruction if it's really firm object in here, and could make packing it up kind of hard. So pack it loosely, roll it loosely. I reckon I could fit a couple of reasonable pillows on the top here as well. Push it to the back there, because what then happens is you fold the tent up to here. And then as you fold this down, this just kind of pushes up against it, and it just fills that space in there. So really, it packs up easily with this bedding inside, so there's actually a true amount of space for it. Now, moving on to pack up now, because that's pretty much all the setup. And while I'm in here, I just want to mention the window. So when you go to pack the tent up, make sure you don't have the inner flap of the windows done up. So I've got the mesh done up here and this flap hanging half down. Reason being that as it folds down, you need to allow the air to escape. I'll move across to where the camera is there now, because I'll show you how you can actually pack this window down while you're inside the tent. So if I just lean out here now, I grab the pole here, unhook the awning from there. I can take this pole out, put it inside, do the same thing on the other side there. Take the pole out, try not to flick here. And you can just leave this hanging down here. I'll do this mesh up and then leave the canvas panel half done up. But don't forget to remove your safety pole from the roof before you get out the tent or before you try and pack it up. And these poles, you probably could actually stash them up with the bedding up the other end of the tent there if you like, or just keep them somewhere else in your car so they're handy and ready to go when you go to set up. Now we go to the front here. The next step for set down is to make sure we've removed the Velcro tabs for these flaps on each side here and remove these two poles. And the fly sheet can just sit loose then over the front of the tent. Now this front door, I think, can either be up or down. I've packed it up both ways. Probably doesn't really matter. There is a stiffener bar in there. So probably the most important thing is you make sure it's sitting straight across the tent and not on an angle, but shouldn't really have an impact. So just let that sit loosely. Make sure we've got our strap down handy here. Doesn't get caught up when we fold it up. And we now grab the ladder on the front here. So if this was extended out, we could do it with the ladder at full extension. But we can now just push this up and over. Before I do it, because it can be hard to reach up over the top, I'm gonna undo the little ladder cover here and let that just sit loose. It's gonna be easier to do that up once it's already undone. Now, we push this up and just be wary as you go to make sure things like the flaps that we put down over the corners here are undone. This should all move really freely now. If you feel it getting caught at any stage, just stop or just give it a wiggle so the fabric all sits down nice and comfortably. You can give it a bit of, there we go. So that, I just pulled that out because it was pulling tight against the fly, but that sat down really comfortably. I didn't have to force it down. Still got our strap free here. Ladder cover can just go down over the top of the ladder there. Just protects this from rubbing against this fabric. And we now need to release the elastic straps underneath here to pull all this fabric in. So grab both of those and pull them up over the top. Just pulling it up over the top of all this fabric so that it holds it in. This just pulls all this in and reduces the amount of fabric that gets caught up in the cover as it's closed down. So from here we grab our strap. If this was on the roof, obviously I'd be standing much lower, so it's a really long strap so you can reach it. We just pull on the strap here. Now it doesn't require a lot of muscle to close this down. It's a pretty easy sort of closure. Pull it down. When you get to a certain point you can still reach inside, just tuck that strap up inside there. And now I can obviously put weight downwards on this, but if you're standing on each side, you just sort of pull down a little bit. Before you go too much further, just check down the sides here and make sure all this fabric is tucked in underneath the cover there. Once you're happy that it's all tucked in, you can then go and put a bit more pressure down to do the latches up. Now, these latches do up easiest of any rooftop tent I played with, but the first ones are harder, so just put a bit of pressure down on the first one, get that looped over and do it up. The second one then is a whole lot easier. Loop that over, do it up. Then we've got our Velcro safety straps here. Do them up, do up our second safety strap here. And if you've got padlocks or anything you want to put through here just to stop this getting done up, do so, and it's nice and secure. That is the Panther 1600 aluminium hard shell rooftop tent. Packed up so much easier than a lot of rooftop tents I've packed up before. That's got a bit of bedding inside. Even with extra bedding inside, I think that would pack down a lot easier. Some of them require a lot of muscle. This one's pretty easy. If you do have any questions on the Panther 1600, let us know down in the comments below. Otherwise, you can check them out online at stowed.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day.